This running bedbug is a well-fed female. And this other one, which very nimbly jumped up on her, is a male who wants very much to xerox his genes on the eggs that this female will lay. You have probably noticed that the male tries to mate somehow crookedly. So it is crookedly. Instead of using hole specially intended for mating, the male pierces the abdominal wall of the female with its reproductive organ, aegagus, and injects his sperm there. This looks quite strange and at least cruel. However, this deviation, at least for us it is not normal, appeared and fixed in the behavior of bedbugs a long time ago, and females have adapted well to it. Exactly in those places where the male penetrates a female body during mating, they developed a special organ in which the sperm is stored and then portionally fertilizes the eggs. Moreover, if the female is starving for a long time and is not up to egg laying, all this male gift dissolves in her and turns into a source of calories. Nevertheless, with all the adaptability of females to such bullying, it is still a very traumatic procedure. For example, males, like all bedbugs, are almost blind, their eyesight is poor, and they navigate mostly by smell. And being in the grip of lust, they try to impregnate almost any creature that moves and even slightly resembles a female in smell and size. Because of this, there is a complete mess in bedbugs clusters. Males try to mate here with both hungry females and with well-fed ones and with nymphs and with other males. In other words, bedbugs' violence, pedophilia and homosexuality reign under your pillow every night and all day long. And studies have shown that many nymphs die after such attempts of rape. If the larva is small, the male kills it by piercing its abdomen. Therefore, nymphs even develop a mechanism to scare off males. They emit a secret with an odor that signals danger. This mechanism is not absolutely reliable, but the very fact of its appearance shows that there is nothing romantic in such bedbug copulation. Several studies have even shown that such traumatic mating shortens lifespan in adult females. Today there is no consensus on how such forced mating evolved and why it proved to be more evolutionarily beneficial for successful breeding than normal copulation, like in a human way. Perhaps it can be related with the habitat of bedbugs, especially in the wild, where they swarm in the bedding of birds' nests or in the mush of bed excrements. And there, in total darkness, males are forced to try to impregnate anyone without much tenderness, in the expectation that if they hit a true female even once, they have already completed their evolutionary task of reproduction. But at the same time, there are many other insect species that live in similar conditions but mate normally, without partners' injuries or traumas, and they do not need to pervert the mating process the way bedbugs do. Here, for example, in our experiment in the video, we have bedbugs sitting in completely uncomfortable conditions for them, under the light, without shelters, on smooth glass, moreover, stained in silica. In a couple of hours, they will all die from silicon dioxide action, but the male, sensing the female, still tries to mate with her anyway. So remember that if these guys have appeared in your apartment, they definitely will not stop on their own and will mate as much and breed as fast as they can. So if you find them in your apartment, kill them immediately. And if you cannot exterminate them, call a person who can. Keep yourself safe from bedbugs.